Hello, Gnana students. Welcome to the social science class about climate, soil, natural vegetation and animals of Karnataka. In this chapter, children, you are all going to study. The learning points are climate of Karnataka. Let us learn. Introduction about climate. Karnataka has tropical monsoon climate. The main characteristics of this climate are hot and moist summers and cool and dry winters. But there is diversity in the climate of the state. The main reason for this diversity are the influence of geographical location, oceans, physical features, vegetation, and monsoon winds. Hence, the annual temperature and distribution of rain are not the same all over the state. Now, let us observe climatic seasons. We can classify the climate of Karnataka over a period of 1 year, as can be done with the climate of India into 4 parts. They are the summer season from March to May, the rainy season June to September, the period of retreating monsoon from October to November, the winter season December to February. Now let us learn detail about these seasons. First month is summer season. During this season, it is very hot, dry and sultry. After March, the temperature rises uniformly all over the state and reaches the maximum during April and May. Raichur has recorded the temperature of 45.6 degrees Celsius and it is the hottest place in Karnataka. The temperature is high even in the other districts of the Northern Maidan. In general, the whole of Karnataka experiences hot climatic conditions during at this time. In summer, due to great evaporation, rain-bearing clouds are produced and they bring conventional rain along with lightning and thunder. The hailstones fall in some places. This generally takes place for a short time during the afternoon. Since these showers enable the flowering of coffee plants, they are called cherry blossoms. And since they help the mango crop, they are also known as mango showers. Now let us observe the rainy season. This is also known as the season of southwest monsoon winds. Winds blowing from the Arabian Sea resulting in heavy rain. Agumbe is an area of heavy rainfall. Hence it is called Chirapunji of South India. During this season, Karnataka receives about 80% of its rainfall. This helps in the cultivation of kharif crops, means monsoon crops. Now let us view the period of retreating monsoon. This is also called the northeast monsoon season. Due to the decrease in temperature and increase in pressure, the winds blow from the northeast to the southwest. These winds are dry because they blow from the land. The winds which blow from the Bay of Bengal bring a little rain to the districts of the Southern Maidan. Besides, due to the cyclones coming from the Bay of Bengal, during the month of November and December, rainfall occurs. During this season, all the states receives about 12% of the rainfall. In this period, the weather conditions are uncertain.
Now let us view the winter season. During this season, temperature, humidity, rainfall are low. The sky is clear. The average temperature is between 25 degree and 27 degree Celsius. January is the month which records the lowest temperature. This is called the tourist month of the state. The Malnad and coastal plains receive heavy rainfall. The eastern maidans are the areas of low rainfall. Often drought and floods occur due to uneven and uncertain rainfall.
Thank you for watching the video. If you really like our video, click on the like button, share and do subscribe. From Gnanajyoti team, alone we can do so little, together we can do so much. For further information, kindly visit our website, that is www.gnanajyoti.com.